and Miss Samantha, and these are their horses. I asked to borrow them. I purposely wanted to put myself in a situation where I didn't know horses and I didn't know the rules. And I thought, you know, it's really great if I can step in here and show you what I would do. Wouldn't you like to know what you would do in this situation, right? So I thought, what a perfect opportunity. So what we're going to do is give these horses a chance to look around and see everything. And my ultimate goal today was to give you the best and most amount of information I can give you in 45 minutes. It's valuable to you that you can go home and maybe practice when you get home. And I'm not going to have anything advanced. I'm going to focus on the things that I love to teach, which is number one, how to fall off and how to get on, those two things. I mean, that happens in life, right? Those are the first bases that we have to touch before we can actually be efficient with horse. So I gave these girls a little bit of a preview of what I was going to do. This horse just saw himself on the big screen. Go ahead. Y'all go ahead and clap for me as loud as you can. To manage and handle a horse's energy. Now, the guy I'm sitting on, this little guy that I'm sitting on, he kind of likes to run a little bit. He's a little fast. And they admittedly told me that he has no brakes. Oh, perfect. Thank you. So I purposely put him in Snapple just so I could teach him to touch on the neck. And that way I would be able to communicate to this horse, hey, I need you to slow down. And for those of you who rode to the horse last year, and were able to watch my demo, I talked about the biggest fear that most riders have is what? Falling off. So we're going to talk about how to do that and what to do. And notice these horses are performing horses, see? And so I'm going to see if we can apply this to both of these girls and this guy. And then when we're done with the touch on the next step, we're going to go over to the fence and we're going to talk about the curbside pickup, which is where you teach your horse to come over to you so you can mount them. Sound good? Okay, we don't have much time, so we're going to try to help these girls as much as we can. So, with the basic handle, all that is putting a cue to the horse that says, hey, by the way, do you mind, could you slow your feet down? Because when a rider gets out of position, and a horse hasn't been shown what to do, things go wrong fast. So, all right, girls, you ready? Okay, we're going to come over here. Now, the first part of the basic handle is the bend. The bend is really simple. You all know what a one rein stop is. That's just slide pulling your horse's head around. It's great for your teeth, actually. They're really good for me. Then, with the basic handle, all we do is just take it up a notch. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a pre-cue to him that says, hey, by the way, do you mind? Could you slow your feet down? And this is what it looks like. If I'm walking to the right, I'm going to turn right. My left hand's going to drop at the base of his neck. I'm going to go up his mane, and I'm going to get really weird. Oh, hey, there's a problem. Do you care? Now, if I was to fall with this horse, do you think he would wait for my dead body, or do you think he'd just keep on going? I mean, he's not vicious, but he's not slowing his feet down. So I will lead his nose out, gather him up, and I will bring him to my belly button, and I'll hold him here till he stops, just like that. So the more times you change and repeat it, the more times you transition and practice it, the faster the horse learns it. So let me go back to the left. I'm going to bend him to the left. So drop my knuckles right here in his mane. I'm going to go all the way up to his ears. Ready? Here it goes. Up the mane. Hey, there's a hole. He went, what the heck? That was weird, lady. You're hanging all over me. Okay. So, girls, what I'm going to have you do is we're going to use you as a demonstration for this. Then I'm going to jump on this horse and speed up and show you a little bit. My goal today is to be able to step off of this horse at a canter. So those of you who don't know what a step off is, that's kind of my signature move where I know I can trust my horse by not pulling back on them, but cueing them that there will be a change that's coming. So let's start with you two girls. I'm going to have you guys take a walk to the left. So those of you who are watching in the audience, I want you to put yourself in their shoes. Okay, so I'm going to break it down for them. Very simple. As you're walking to the left, you're going to drop your right hand and you're going to go up the horse's mane and say, hey, please slow down. And really what that does is it allows you to get your bearings and prepare you for the stop. Good. And you're going to hold them there until your belly button, just like that. Okay, good. Now let's go back to the left. So reverse your direction. Did you want to turn left? We just went left. Let's go right. And truly what I love more than anything is being right here with the rider, showing you what it looks like. So, all right, you're going to bend your horse to the left, to the right. So your left hand is going to drop. You're going to go up the horse's mane and say, I need you to slow down. Could you please? If they don't, that's okay. We just redirect. I'm going to hold him here until he stops. Perfect. Okay, good. Now, I'm gonna single you out because I wanna, earlier when we were out here, I worked with you and I was like, okay, I want you to do this. So I want you to trot. And I want you to trust him. See, because he sees all this stuff going on. There's a big jumbotron. And this is something we can't simulate anywhere else. So this is a scary thing for him. And I know it's a scary thing for you. So what I'm gonna have you do is just trot. We're gonna stand right here. I just want you to trot. And when you're ready, I want you to go up his mane and just really push up his mane. Let him feel you that there's a change. See if he slows down at all. Let's just see. Go ahead. We'll wait for you. This will be good. Now see, he's gated, and the reason I wanted him to be in this demo is because there's a lot of gated horse owners here. Am I right? Raise your hand if you have a gated horse. Okay, good. That's okay. Good. All right, good. So she's cruising around. You're doing good. Okay. Good. What do we see there? Good. Okay, let's go back to the right. Let's do one more of those. Back to the right. Now, the cool thing about doing the basic handle is the more times you change in transition, the faster you learn it. And this is about your rein management and, what else, your body control. You have to have control of your body and your tools, otherwise you're not really communicating to your horse. Good girl. I'm really proud of you. You're doing great. Okay, so you're going to bend your horse to the right. So go up the mane with your left hand, push. Good. Sit up and pull. And earlier when I was in the back with them, I said, the key to the basic handle is mirroring the horse and the energy of the horse. So if the horse is willing and soft, you're willing and soft. If they get a little pushy, they blow you off, you just go, okay. You still redirect. Okay, so now I'm going to kick you out there soon. You're going to practice. You can go stand by the daddy. Good. How was that? Better? Okay. Good girl. Okay, so just take a walk. If you feel comfortable, go ahead and trot for me. Good. Good. Okay, now drop your right hand and go up his mane and just wait. Push, 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 push. Wait, wait, wait. There it is. Lead his nose out, out, and then lift to your belly button, belly button. Good. Hold him there to his legs. Okay, perfect. Go back to the right. Now, these are drill horses, so obviously they want to be magnetized to the horses here, so I can't blame him. But the horse will start to understand what you're actually communicating to them. Okay, trot forward. She's going to be turning to the right. So her left hand is going to go up the mane. Wait. Now, see, he sped up, didn't he? He went, well, I'll see you later. Okay, so for the reason of time, this is what I'm going to have you do to help him understand. I want you to go on the wall. And you're going to let him trot off. You're going to drop your hands, stay low, and now you're going to turn it into a roll back or a roll away into the fence. But you pre-cue him that there's a change coming. So that turn to the right, the horse kind of, you know, blew her off. This is a really great way to say, hey, I need you to slow down. So go up the mane with your left hand. Go up the mane. Good. See, the horse kind of doesn't, he's not connecting the dots, so that's okay. Sit up and pull. Change hands. Good job. Now drop your right hand, go up his mane. Good. And say, whoa. Good. Now I want you to trot. And you'll notice that the rider has to practice changing and being out of position. Because let's face it, when a rider falls off, they're normally in this position. Which is exactly why she's wearing a bucket for her brain on her head. She's trying to protect herself. Good job. Okay, good. Trot forward again. One more to the right. Go up his mane, say, whoa. Now, when you do that, go like this. Bump, release his head. You don't want to hang on him. You always want to release if you can. Okay, so trot him forward. Good job. Okay, go up his mane. Oh, bump, release. Good. Turn and look. Good job. Okay, good. Now, I'm going to have you come join me, and I'm going to ride. I think his name's Buddy. Let me speed him up because they told me he likes to go, so good job. Okay, so now, what is the rider, including me, it's falling off. So I'm going to use this horse as a demonstration. And right now you notice I'm not really guiding him too much. I'm just letting him move. Okay, he wants to go fast, that's fine. Notice I don't pick him. I'm just like, hey, there we go. All right. Okay, I'm going to ask him for the touch on the neck. Let me just see if he'll respond to that. Ready? Hey, there's a problem. I'm going to die. Okay, good. This is the weirdest drill I've ever been in. Good. Now, I'm purposely testing him. See, his shoulder's really drawn to them, so I'm going to go to the other end of the arena. Because this part of the arena loves to see the paint. You know, in 45 minutes, they go, hey, what can I get done? Good job. Okay. Oh, nope, he wants to cut back. Okay, we're going to go back up here. Redirect. Okay, good. Is he? Oh, nope, he wants to see his friends. Okay. Hold him here till he's soft, friends. This is a good question because people say, well, how long do I hold on to him? You just see how he's not soft, so just wait. And I just become the passenger, and I just let him pick it up. Right here, you can relax and release them, and then reverse, repeat. So I'm gonna go back to the left. Now, I told you earlier my goal was to step off of him at the canter. I'm a little scared. I'm just being honest. Okay, let's let him cruise around here. Let's see how fast he is. So when a horse moves, what did I just do? I stood up. Why did I stand up? So that I'm not pulling on him, I'm just gonna get out of his way. Well, that's not a bad canter. Okay, now when I feel secure, I go, okay, I can sit down and ride that. Okay, I'm gonna put him to the test. I'm gonna drop his name over here. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Hey, you can, that was better. Okay, he slowed down enough for me to kind of redirect him. Good. Now, this horse, I believe, is in his 20s, is that right? He's older, isn't he? Okay, he's an older horse. Do I expect him to have perfection? Absolutely not. What I'm trying to communicate to him is, hey, by the way, do you mind, could you slow your feet down so that I can be clear? I don't want to pull on him all the time, okay? I'm going to go with me. There, that was better. Good, there was some softness in his breath. Good. Hold him here until he steps. Good boy. Okay. Now, I'm going to turn him into the rollback. Then I'm going to fall off of him because all of you want to watch me fall. Because I did that well in Wound of the Horse last year. Really well. I'm gonna turn this into a rollback. Here's what it is. And you girls can actually join me, just get on a wall, and we'll practice really quick. This is what we're gonna do. So you're gonna drop down the fence line, or whatever your horse would like to do, and then go up the mane and say, whoa, whoa, there's an emergency. Whoops, sir. Whoa, whoa. See, this is why you can't say whoa to your horse. You notice he doesn't care or speak English. Where's he going? To his friends. So as a rider, I have to be able to redirect. Now, I have to trust him and not pull on him. And when I talked to Joyce, who's their director, she said, this horse gets pulled on, so he's never had his freedom. You can see he doesn't know. See, he knows where he's dragging me to. So the reason I love this exercise is because it's a lie detector to me of how the horse handles themselves. And are they really with me? Whoa, hi, sir. There, that's a good boy. See, he wants to duck and dive his shoulders. I'm not going to change that today. I'm not going to change that today. No, I'm just going to introduce, hey, there's a problem, I might die. Thank you. No, that was good. I said, shorten your rein. Shorten it. Now, this is a prime example, and I'm really glad that just happened. Biggest issue with most riders when they're learning is their rein management. So her rein got a little long there. So the neat thing about doing the touch on the neck is you practice sliding and getting your rein short, just like that. So that was a good practice. Sit up, go ahead and sit up and hold him there until he stops. Perfect. Okay, go back to the right. Okay. So let's speed up. Hold on. We go one more time against the rollback. Then we're going to talk about falling off. We're going to make these girls fall off. See, he wants his friends. Second he sees them, he's like, I'd like to go that way. Good boy. Okay, back to him. So, okay, girls, do you want to practice falling? Every lesson, you're like, yeah, I'd love to practice falling. I'd love to fall off. Okay, I'm going to fall off. I'll start. Ready? Watch. Oh, we're going to wait. Oh, that's real life. Now, this is just a person riding a horse, but sometimes things are out of your control. I can't control that. He has to wait for me to tell him what to do. And because horses are very single-minded, we make things complicated. Sometimes we gotta simplify things. So, I want you to try and fall off over here, right here in the middle. Okay, you girls, boys, ladies, gentlemen, watch. I want you to watch your horse's feet, let go of his head, just go fall off. Grab his neck. There it is. Life, good, hold. Now, how would you back him up without touching his head? Watch, guys. Can you move your horse without touching their head? Could you? Good. So for me, when I first teach, when I fall around their neck, Which means if I had an incident where a horse got out of control, I could safely get my feet on the ground. Does that make sense? Okay, so even if she falls, if she has something to hold on to, her head is up so her feet can be on the ground. Okay, so I want you to do the exact same thing. I want you to reach up. When I tell people fall, what I mean by that is move your body to the left of the saddle horn or the right, reach up, stop. Thank you for learn to get your head up. Good. Okay, did you fall? She's like, just walk. I just want you to walk. Take your feet out of your stirrups. Lean over to the left and fall off. Grab his neck. Let go of his head. Fall off of his neck. Get there, get there, get there. Don't hesitate. Tell him we have a problem. Thank you. Now, I know that this is hard, and I appreciate her honesty because she looked at me and went, oh. I realize it's scary, but let me tell you, when you have a relationship with your horse where you can communicate to them, hey, you got a problem, and you need to get down like right now, the second you get weird, they go, yep. So I want this horse to understand the language that I'm speaking to him. Okay, so girls, we're going to do it one more time. I think I want to step off of him at the canter because I said I would and I'm scared and I'm just going to show you that I get scared sometimes and I have to do hard things. You guys don't mind, do you? You don't mind? Okay, I have no idea what he's going to do. It's live TV. It's fine. It's fine. Girls, you want to fall off some more? Okay, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm a little bit terrified. Oh no, they go, oh you're so not fearful. I'm like, oh yeah, actually I am. So let me work through my hair and then I'm gonna go step off of him and wherever I feel it's necessary to give him a ship. And he's not my horse, so no promises, okay? Let's get some good TV. Okay, I'm gonna let him freeze here for a second. Notice I stood up. They're like, oh, the drill started. He's actually pleasant fellow. Notice he doesn't go straight though, so I'm just trying to keep it straight so that I can get his. Okay, maybe not. We'll do it over here. I just got faster, so I went. Okay, this is where you pull the Hail Mary. Oh no, he's going really fast. Hold on. I'm going to speed up even more. Just because you guys are all on the edge of your seat. I'm on the edge of my seat. Okay, ready? Here we go. One, two. He totally did it. Oh, I love my job. It's so cool. First of all, number one thing, you never know unless you try. Don't make excuses. Get active. Get smart with your hands. Get smart with your feet. Get smart with your equipment. Teach your horses how to come save your life. Stop micromanaging. Redirect, guide, allow. That was so good. That was trust. I trusted him. He trusted me. That was scary, you guys. You could be so difficult. That was a nice gesture. Wait, see, he just, bye, see you later. You're not getting on, are you? I mean, I was just going to go to the barn and unsaddle myself. I'm trying to get. Are you having any fun? Okay, good. Are you having any fun, Samantha? Okay. Just for the sense of time's sake, are we learning? Do we understand? Do you want to canter and try to touch him on the neck or do anything at the canter? Do you feel comfortable doing that? I think you should canter. Okay, high five, go. Go, go, go. We'll stay, we'll wait right here for you. Me and Samantha will stay here and we'll get this in. Hold on, my kid. Okay, now, Samantha, the thing with this is, I just want you to go up his mane. Can you just fall? See what he does. Go up his mane. Push hard. Push. Go. There. There. Good girl. Now pull his nose around. There you go. Hold him there until he stops. Good job. Good girl. Excellent. Hold him there until he stops. That's a good job. Good. Samantha, how about you? You want to practice one more time? That was good. She did it at the canter. Of course I want you to do it at the canter. Nobody's watching. You guys are not watching. Tell them. She's doing great. Listen, I pulled them into the deep end and I'm like, we're gonna swim. And they're like, you don't get floaties? I'm like, where are you going? Go, this is good. This is how you teach riders to ride under movement and how to ride and die with a strike. let her just cruise around. I like that you went down there, thank you. Okay, how would you slow down, or fall off, or stop your horse at that moment? What does she do? Everybody watch her hands. Okay, what do you do? Good, good, sit up, take it, bump his nose, good. Good job. Good, and she handled that exactly the same way. If your horse gets worried, if your horse is going farther or faster than you're comfortable with, change it. Don't panic. Take a call, like get the action happening. Move your body, change it. Okay, girls, let's go ahead and pull the saddles off. We're gonna talk about the curve.